First of all, it was a very difficult decision, and I respect Senator Franken for the work that he has done as a senator on issues that are right now a lot of issues that we are fighting, like DACA and what we're doing around immigration. I think he's done good work as it relates to those kinds of issues. But frankly, the numerosity and of the complaints and allegations against him, I found to have weight, a carry weight. So it was a lot different when I made the decision.
This is pretty remarkable that in just a span of maybe 30 minutes or so, the number of senators who have all come out at the same time to make this decision to call on Senator Franken to resign. And obviously, this is something that we have been keeping track of over the last couple of weeks as these stories, allegations of sexual harassment began to mount against Senator Franken. And up until this point, the silence was pretty remarkable, whether it was, you know, female senators or male senators, Democrats or Republicans. These members were very, very reluctant, obviously, to call on Franken to resign. And I think today we saw sort of a turning point where it took one member, that was Kirsten Gillibrand, to first say that she is calling on him to resign. And then obviously there were a slew of other members who then decided to sort of hit the press, the send button.